Hey, what's up Blender users, I'm Jonathan, and in today's video I'm gonna walk you through the process of creating a pillow in Blender 2.83 using the new cloth tools. I will not only show you how to create this inflated pillow you see all the time in other tutorials, but rather show you the method I use to integrate it better into your scene to achieve renders like this one rather than this one. And by the way, if you enjoy my content, consider subscribing, because I upload a new video every Saturday. And with that said and done, let's get straight into the video. Okay, for the sake of this tutorial, I prepared this little scene right here. I just loaded in an HDRI and modeled this wall. The texture I used is from Polygon. It's just a simple free wood texture. And I modeled just this little beveled edge here to make it a little bit more realistic. I placed the camera right here facing the wall with some depth of field to make it a bit more interesting. And now we're gonna add the pillow. For this, I created this new collection called Pillow, and we're gonna add in a cube. There are two ways to create a pillow that I know of, and I'm just gonna show you both. Okay, so I'm just gonna disable the collection and now duplicate this cube so we can create both pillows. For the first cube, I'm gonna go into edit mode, scale it down on the Z-axis, like this, and now also on the X-axis to give it a pillow shape. Now we will have to add some loop cuts, so press Ctrl and R and click on the mesh like this, and now we can adjust the number of cuts, and I'm gonna use 50. And we will also need some cuts on this side, and for this I'm as well gonna choose 50. And for this side we will use one loop cut, just like this. So what we will now do is add the cloth physics to this mesh, go to frame 1, and first of all disable gravity. And because we want the pillow to inflate itself, we go under pressure, enable pressure, and give it a pressure of, for example, 5. And we can also adjust the quality steps to, for example, 8. And now if we play this animation, we can see that we get this nice pillow, just like this. We can now run the simulation until a frame we like, like this, and we can also adjust the pressure value to a higher number to get just a faster simulation, like this. If we now go ahead and subdivide our mesh, we can really start to see the pillow form. But there's also a different method of creating a pillow using sewing. For this, I'm gonna just go again into edit mode, scale the cube to a pillow shape, just like this. And also now add some loop cuts. We don't want loop cuts on the side because we will delete the faces. Stay in edit mode, go into wireframe, press 1. So you go into the orthographic side view and press 3. So we can select the faces and select all the faces on the side. Now press X and delete only the faces. So we still have the edges right here. We can now also add cloth, and again go to frame 1. We can also adjust the quality steps to, for example, 8. And again use pressure. I'm gonna use a pressure value of 10. But now we want to enable sewing. This will now drag the mesh together. If we now play this animation, you can see that the mesh gets dragged together and we also get a pillow. But now the thing is, we get this seam right here where the mesh isn't together because it doesn't merge. So I personally really like this option right here because we still get this seam, which makes it a bit more realistic, but it's a whole mesh and we don't have to add faces later on. So I'm just gonna delete this pillow and find a frame I like for this pillow right here. And for me, this is probably gonna be right here. So now select the pillow, and we can go into the modifiers panel and apply the cloth. Now we have this pillow, and we can also scale up this edge right here to get this seam. Now, because we are in Blender 2.83 with the new cloth brush that Pablo added a few days ago, we can go into the sculpt node and add some more wrinkles. If you didn't scale your mesh in the edit mode, you will now have to apply the scale to have the brush circular. And we can now just drag on the mesh to create wrinkles. Of course, we will have to adjust the size of our brush and also the cloth settings. So we can adjust the cloth mass to make it a bit easier to drag around. And we can also change the deformation to, for example, drag right here and add just some more wrinkles. I don't think I want this many wrinkles on this mesh because it kind of looks good as it is right now. So we'll start integrating it into our scene. For this, I'm gonna enable my scene back and now move the pillow to a place I want it to be. So move it up and move it to here. I'm also gonna scale it up a bit, just like this. You can also see that I'm using a matte cap. I just went to matte cap and enabled shadow so you can see where the pillow is in my scene. Okay, now to integrate it and not have it be like this inflated pillow object, we can again go into the cloth physics, enable it, and now just run the simulation again with no settings changed. But I want the cloth before the subdivision surface modifier so it simulates a bit faster. Now we can just run it and we can see that if we stop it at a frame where we can still see a pillow, it kind of integrates better into our scene like this. I want it to be a bit on the wall, so I'm just gonna go back to frame 1, press 7 and move the pillow above this edge right here, so the final placement looks a bit more interesting. I will also have to note that I of course enabled collision for this object, for my wall and ground, because otherwise this just won't work. So I'm just gonna choose a frame that I like, for example this one right here, and now we can again go ahead, apply the cloth and move it a bit down because the collision doesn't really work on this small of a scale. So move it down like this, and now I will have to adjust the depth of field of the camera so it sits on the pillow just like this, and we can now go into rendered view and preview our scene. And just like this, you can easily create a pillow and integrate it into your room, into your scene, and place it wherever you want. I hope you liked this tutorial, I hope you found it kind of helpful, and if you did, consider subscribing and liking this video, and we're gonna see us next Saturday.